Hello YouTube, Empathy Relics here, and today I'm bringing you guys a commentary over something a little bit different. So the gameplay that you're watching in the background is some Infamous First Light gameplay. It's like the arena challenges that you needed to do if you wanted to get the game platinum. And yeah, it's kind of entertaining to watch. I found it fun as to play, so I don't really know whether you guys will enjoy watching it or not, but hopefully you do. And yeah, it's just something a little bit different, something other than Black Ops 3, and hopefully you enjoy it. So anyway, today what I wanted to talk about was 10 games, 10 up-and-coming games that I'm really looking forward to. So these games don't necessarily have to be confirmed, although like I'm kind of, you know, only picking the ones that are confirmed or at least very likely to happen. So there'll be no Half-Life 3 or anything in this list. And yeah, they're kind of in order, like not strictly in order, but the ones I'll mention at the start are the ones that are like less down the chain, and the ones I mention later on will be the ones I really am looking forward to. So I'll start off. Number 10 is Days Gone. So I believe that's the name of it. I probably should have double checked, but I saw the trailer of it. This is another zombie game, which... zombie games, you know, they're kind of a little bit tiresome. People are growing tired of them, but it looks really good, to be honest. But they only showed a few minutes of gameplay in the trailer, and it just showed a shit ton of zombies and how you can manipulate the environment around you to try and combat against them and slow them down and stuff. You know, I'm down for a zombie game. I do like zombie games and I do like shooters. So it does look pretty good, but it's 10th on my list because... really, that I don't really know a lot about it, who's making it and whatnot, so that's the reason why. Number 9, Resident Evil 7, sorry. So Resident Evil 7, I played Resident Evil 5 and 6. I enjoyed both of those games. I think they're underrated. I think they get hated on a little bit too much from the older Resident Evil fans. But yeah, hopefully Resident Evil 7 is good. And... who knows, there's probably going to be zombies in it as well. There were zombies in Resident Evil 6. But yeah, I played Resident Evil 6. I bought it like a year ago and played it like, what, I think I finished it 4 months ago or something. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. I got plenty of game time out of it because there were four different campaigns that were pretty long. And I got my money's worth and I enjoyed the game a lot. So hopefully Resident Evil 7... is good, and if it is good, I'll definitely be getting it. So number 8, I've got Crash Bandicoot. I haven't really seen a lot from Crash Bandicoot. All I know that it was confirmed at E3 that there will be a Crash Bandicoot game. I imagine it's going to be a new one and not just remastered one. At least from the gameplay I saw, it looked to be a completely new game. And yeah, hopefully they can update it a little bit while still having the old school feel, because I grew up playing Crash Bandicoot on the PlayStation 1, so it'd be really cool if they could make a good Crash Bandicoot game like they did with the Ratchet & Clank game. And if they do, yeah, hopefully they don't release it for full price and put it down to like $40 or something when it comes out, which would be really, really good. But yeah, hopefully Crash Bandicoot is a success, because I think everyone... like, who doesn't like Crash Bandicoot? Because... Maybe some of the young kids didn't really play it when they were growing up, but I played it on the PS1 and PS2. Absolutely loved it, and I'd love to see it on PS4. So at number 7, I got No Man's Sky. The reason why No Man's Sky is so low on the list is because I really don't think it'll live up to its expectations and live up to the hype that it set. Because, what, when they released the first trailer, when people first heard about No Man's Sky, they saw... this massive, massive, massive world with dinosaurs and planets and like a whole universe to explore, and it kind of had like endless possibilities, and they promised so much. If they can deliver on all those promises and make a game that's fun to play and works and isn't boring, which is my main concern of it, it'll be absolutely awesome. But I honestly don't think, especially since it's been delayed further, I really don't think it'll live up to the hype. I don't think it'll be that good of a game. But I hope they prove me wrong, because it does look really good. So number 6, I've got Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare. the remaster. So I'm not saying Infinite Warfare, no way in hell am I saying that, but COD 4, I'm really interested, but I kind of want to like put this one with the rest of the trilogy. I hope that they do remaster Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3, and if they do, I hope they release it in a trilogy, and then if they do that, I'll purchase the trilogy. But since Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 aren't really confirmed, I'll just say COD 4 for now. But yeah, hopefully they release COD 4 as standalone a few months after Infinite Warfare comes out. If they do and there's a large enough player base, I'll definitely get it, because I never got to play COD 4 back on the PS3, so I'm interested to see if they add trophies to it as well, because if they do, I'd like to try and get a platinum, because I have got a fair few of the Call of Duty games platinum, and I enjoy their campaigns, and apparently COD 4 has the best campaign, and I haven't played it yet, so looking forward to it. Number five, I've got The Walking Dead Season 3. I'm a massive Telltale fan. I've played most of their games, and the ones I haven't played, I've bought, except for a few of the older ones on PS3. Because the main reason I buy them is for the trophies, but I do love their games as well. I've played The Walking Dead Season 1 and 2. Love both of those games. Season 3 has been confirmed, and I'm really looking forward to it. And yeah, so hopefully it's good. Well, we'll know it's going to be good because Telltale is making it, and Telltale rarely make a bad game, so yeah, really looking forward to it. Love the episodic adventures. My only issue with it is that you have to wait like a month for an episode to come out, so I'll just wait till it goes on sale and buy it afterwards when all the episodes are out. So number four, I got Battlefield 1. I need to satisfy my shooter craving. I bought Battlefield 4 and Hardline because they were on sale just yesterday. And yeah, I'm not really a massive Battlefield fan. Like, I started playing Battlefield. It was my first actual online shooter, Battlefield Bad Company 2, and I played a bit of 3. But I'm not a massive fan. It doesn't really keep me coming back. That being said, I do enjoy playing it and kind of over COD, so hopefully Battlefield 1's really good, and hopefully there's a large player base to keep me playing, because at the moment it's a bit hard to find games on the other two Battlefield games. But yeah, looking forward to Battlefield 1. World War 1 shooter, that sounds absolutely epic. The gameplay looks sick for it, and yeah, really looking forward to it. So at number 3, I got The Last of Us 2. The only game on this list that isn't confirmed is The Last of Us 2. As far as I know, it hasn't been confirmed, but the ending of The Last of Us 1 kind of hinted that there was going to be The Last of Us 2. So, really looking forward to it. Last of Us, the original, is probably the best game ever. I haven't played it yet, but I did watch the walkthrough as soon as it came out. So I basically played it, but I haven't physically played it yet, which I'm just waiting for it to go on sale on the PS4, and I'll get the remastered edition. But I've got so many other games to play ahead of it to even worry about getting that game. But yeah, I definitely want to play The Last of Us, and The Last of Us 2, dare say, will be Game of the Year when it comes out. So hopefully they confirm it soon. Hopefully we get it next year, or at least in 2018. I don't want to have to wait too long. And yeah, since Naughty Dog have finished with Uncharted 4, I dare say that The Last of Us 2 is in the works. So number 2, I've got Deus Ex Mankind Refined. I believe that's the name. Don't quote me on that, but it's definitely a Deus Ex game. But yeah, it looks really, really good. I've only seen like 15 minutes of gameplay. I don't really know how much of it's been released yet, but I was a massive fan of Deus Ex Human Revolution, and yeah, it was one of my favorite games on the PS3. I hired it and absolutely loved that game. I'd love to buy it. Hopefully they remaster it for the PS4. If they did that, I'd definitely pick it up, because it was a really, really good game, and hopefully Deus Ex Mankind Refined can have that kind of story. Even improve the story, which would be very hard to do because I had a great plot the first one, and then improve a few of the other things like the gameplay. And yeah, I dare say if they can improve upon the original, it will definitely be Game of the Year this year. And number one, the game I'm looking forward to the most is Mass Effect Andromeda. So I'm kind of sad that the Mass Effect trilogy ended how it ended, but hopefully this is the start of a new trilogy, a new Mass Effect trilogy. I believe it's set far into the future of the other games, so I absolutely love the Mass Effect universe. I'm a massive fan of their games. I think that the Mass Effect trilogy is three of like the best games ever made. I haven't played Mass Effect 3 yet, but played 1 and 2, and Mass Effect 3 I do own, just haven't got around to playing it yet. But yeah, hopefully Mass Effect Andromeda can really hit the high notes that the original trilogy hit, and can create a crew and a world as immersive as it did. New ship looks awesome, Tempest I believe it's called. Yeah, so I'm really pumped for that game. Definitely one of the ones I'll pre-order if it does come out, so hopefully it comes out soon. Hopefully there's no delays for it. And yeah, so they're the 10 games I'm looking forward to. I've probably missed some. I wouldn't be surprised if I missed some. If I have, let me know in the comment section below what you're looking forward to. Doesn't have to be confirmed, but it has to be likely. So, you know, Half-Life 3 fans, it's not going to happen, I'm sorry. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this, something a little bit different. And yeah, let me know in the comments what games you're looking forward to. And I'll see you guys in the next one.